there's something Audi doesn't want you to know. Come a little bit closer for this. A little bit closer. A little bit closer. Not that close. Back up a little bit. You might be wondering, what is lifetime? What are all these kits in front of me, and what does lifetime mean for fluids? We're going to be going over what exactly lifetime fluids mean in this scenario, what all of these kits are, where you even drain and fill them from, and just how to service your entire driveline and transmission system for your B9, S4, or S5. Let's go ahead and take a closer look. Let's go over the transmission and driveline guide for the Audi B9 platform. So the Audi B9 platform initially introduced in 2017 for the US, and it offers a variety of transmission options depending on the model and drivetrain configuration. Most notably, the performance-oriented S4 and S5 models are exclusively equipped with a traditional automatic, the ZF 8HP. This is a torque converter-based automatic, and it replaces the dual clutch many have come to know and love in the B8.5, S4, and S5, and it was chosen due to higher torque capacity to support the EA839 engine. The ZF 8HP also offers quick, crisp shifts and adaptive programming, making it versatile for both spirited driving and comfort-focused cruising. For non-S models like the A4, A5, and Allroad, Audi offered multiple transmissions depending on the engine and drivetrain layout. Now, they did offer a front-wheel drive variant, which was primarily sold outside of North America, and those were available with a 7-speed dual-clutch S-tronic DL382, while quattro all-wheel drive models received a longitudinally mounted version of the same 7-speed dual-clutch. Now, more rare than this transmission option is that you could get a manual in the B9 A4 and A5. This was primarily between 2017 and 2018 and was designated as the OBD2 6-speed manual gearbox. This was used very limited for the A5 coupe for one model year only, and very briefly for the tail end of the A4s. So you're not going to come across this transmission very frequently out in the wild. If you are looking for a manual, we highly recommend jumping on whatever spec you find, because there are so few out there in the world. The popular ZF 8HP is utilized in the 3.0T and 2.9 twin turbo models respectively. This is a traditional automatic with a torque converter and is renowned for not only its high power, high torque capacity, but its performance and speed. It is regarded by many as the best traditional automatic transmission available and is used widely across various manufacturers. The switch was made as the 8HP is smoother, nearly as fast shifting as the dual clutch, and has a much higher torque capacity than the S-tronic boxes. Let's go over some of the driveline in these examples. The RS5 uses standard quattro all-wheel drive with self-locking center differentials, and this offers high precision handling through active torque distribution. The A5 and S5 uses standard quattro all-wheel drive. 2018 A5s only could receive quattro with Ultra technology only when optioned with a 6-speed manual transmission, which is only exclusive to the coupe variant. The A4 Allroad uses standard quattro all-wheel drive with Ultra technology. A4 is available with quattro all-wheel drive with self-locking center differential and wheel selective torque control for front-wheel drive for 2017, 2018, 2019, and 2020. The S4 is standard quattro all-wheel drive. Overall, they don't really share a whole lot in common, but they all share an issue of rear axles shifting or being misaligned. So if you're experiencing any premature tire wear or bolt snapping or straining, that might be the source of your cause. So be sure to take a look underneath your car to make sure that the rear axle is not snapping hardware. All right, so let's go over some of the general service intervals that Audi has issued. Audi splits up service into minor service and standard service categories, with some variations and exceptions by model. The full list can be found here and is generally the same year over year, with some exceptions as models come and go or new engines or transmissions are added. It is also worth noting that there is some lifetime verbiage thrown out there. We're going to be going into a higher pass on some of the services you might need. So for filter changes, Audi recommends usually every 40,000 miles. Now granted, for the manuals on this platform, there is no listed fluid change just because they are so rare and limited. Here at FCP Euro, we recommend replacing that every 40 to 50,000 miles. The sport differential fluids and rear differential fluid is recommended by Audi every 40,000 miles. At that same interval, they want you to check for the automatic transmission and final drive. Check those for leaks, the drive shaft as well, and front and rear axle, check those for play. At that same notation, we want to also say check your manual transmission for any leaks or anything of that nature as well at that similar mileage. So let's go over really quickly, what are the kits I have in front of me? We have everything here from simple drain and fill kits for your B9, S4, or S5 to massive overhauls and filter changeovers. We have all of the kits here you're gonna need for the front diff, rear diff, transfer case, obviously the transmission oil itself here, but we also have all of the hardware you could want and the pan, which includes the filter itself into it. Now, it might be useful to do so because you're gonna want to probably drop the subframe on the B9 S4 and S5 to actually be able to successfully remove the oil pan for the transmission. As you can see, this little section here, if you look into this material, this is actually your filtration material. It's integrated into the pan. So if you're gonna do that big of a job and take down the subframe, you might as well just do all of these service intervals all at once so you know they're all done at the same time. You can only buy these bolts from ZF for the service kit in a kit. So what better way to do this job than to just do it all at once? Over here, we're gonna be talking about the rear diff to start. Now, our example is equipped with the sport diff. So what that means is you're going to need both the standard oil for just the standard cars not equipped with the sport diff, and then the sport diff fluid itself. So this is what the kit looks like if you need a sport diff. If you do not have a sport diff, you just get this guy. Over here, we have the transfer case fluid. That's pretty self-explanatory. And then the front diff fluid. Obviously over here, as I mentioned before, we have the oil pan itself integrated in with the filter, the hardware for that. And then over here, we have the transmission fluid itself. Now I have, I think, about 7 of these liters here on the table, but notate if you're doing a complete drain and filter change, like you would when you're changing out this pan here, you're probably going to need about 9 liters for your example. Now let's take a look under the car so we can actually get some bearings on where the drain and fill sections are for all of these different fluids and what it might look like to actually gain access to drain or fill the fluid on those mechanisms. Let's take a look now at some of the components here underneath the car, where they're located, and just what you're gonna have to do to get true access to all of the drain and fill locations on this. Now, if we take a look at the transmission pan here, you can see the drain and fill is very accessible, super easy to get in contact with, but it is important to note, if you look at the transmission mount and the subframe, you look at just how big and vast this pan is, you're not going to be able to get access to actually dropping the filter and replacing the entire pan with the subframe installed. So, like I said before, if you want to just devote an entire weekend to doing all of the fluids that have to do with your driveline, just do it, because you drop the subframe here, you get a lot more access even into the front differential here. And if you take a closer look behind my shoulder here, you can see that while the drain plug is very accessible here, the fill is really tucked in here. So to give you as much room, you know, room for activities, room to be comfortable, drop this thing out of the way, get rid of it, you know? So for the transfer case back here, you're gonna see you have this recess, this carving out in the stamping here. Your drain is gonna be tucked under this, and then your fill is actually right here. So you might be sitting here and wondering, well, how do I know if I actually have a sport differential on my B9? There's 3 different ways to tell. Number one, just check your MMI system. Do you have the individual package listed out? Can you control your driving parameters as a result of that? 2, do you have red brakes? Red brakes are often alluded to the sport diff package. If you're looking at an example that has been modified, it's important to know whether or not those red brakes may have been added on by someone else at some point. But if you know that the car is fairly stock, then there's a good chance that it's gonna have the sport differential equipped. And then lastly, if you're under the car already, like myself, you're gonna notice that you're gonna have this actuator here, this motor that's going to control the sport diff mechanism. That's a tried and true way of knowing whether or not you have a sport diff. Now that we've located all of the drain and fill locations on everything having to do with the driveline system on your B9, S4, or S5, let's head back over to the table. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and got a closer look into lifetime fluids, what that means, and that it means not lifetime of the car, but rather lifetime of the warranty cycle on this platform. Now, if you guys are unsure whether or not you want to tackle these DIYs and you want to get a closer look onto the play-by-play of each, go ahead, click on our channel, look at the B9 S5 playlist. Rusty went over all of these step-by-step for DIY videos. You can watch those to get some more confidence, and you can shop all of the kits on fcpeuro.com. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hit like if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe if you want to see more B9 content, and comment below if you have any feedback. We'll see you on the next one.